Namaste. Do you all know where we are headed to? We're living on this planet. Have you ever felt that there is something, some kind of a danger lurking around all of us? We don't have time to reflect, think about what is in store for us. It's important for we human beings to actually look around and see what is there for us to take note of. Judge Bernard Shaw once said that man has learned how to fly and learned how to swim the oceans, but he is yet to learn how to live on this planet. So, all of us need to understand why we should know what's happening in this world, on this beautiful planet Earth. There's a one serious challenge that is shaking the humanity, the very survival of the humanity and human race, never before seen or felt or experienced. As the world is warming up, the globe is warming up to climate change, we are all in a sort of uncertain future. If you just want to know why it's happening, as a citizen of the world, as a global human being, as a citizen of this country or any other country, if you just wish to know, wonder what's happening in this world, one thing tells you very clearly, instructs you very clearly, that there is something wrong, seriously wrong with the climate, with our environment, with our biodiversity. Something is seriously wrong. Why is this happening? What actually is happening on the earth that becomes dangerous for us to survive? You know, the temperatures are rising. Oceanic temperatures are rising. Forests are burning. You take one example, just 3 days ago, when the TED was conducting its climate change program, Israel, Lebanon, and Syria, these three countries recorded forest burns, and thousands of people had to flee. And also, even the glaciers are ready to melt, because the temperatures are going up like anything. It's going towards 1.5 degrees Celsius. Now it's predicted that by 2040, it may go to 2%, 2 degrees Celsius. 2060, it will be 3 degrees Celsius. 2080, it will be 4 degrees. And 2080, it's 5 degrees. What will happen to this Earth? If you look at pre-industrial times of the climate, it was sometimes minus also, 0.16. Today we are at 1.1 plus something. So as the temperatures are causing, rising, why are the temperatures rising? Because of this climate change. Why is this climate changing? Because of, you know, of certain things that are happening around us. And Bob Hopkins said, unless and until we fix this climate change through right economy, probably we are going to run into serious existential crisis. United Nations Global Environment Outlook Report 2019 also says that the Earth is becoming increasingly unhealthy because of its biodiversity, because of its climate change, and air, water, and oceanic pollution. temperature rise, and how hazardous it will be for us. And what's happening with all these things? The air is becoming impure. What we're breathing today is not oxygen. We require tons and tons of oxygen. We all in the world, but what we're breathing is something different. What we're drinking, the water, is not clean water. It's contaminated. And the food that we take also is not the food that we are supposed to take. So with the pollution everywhere around and the ecosystem is getting impacted adversely or negatively, and it forming into the very carbon dioxide, is completely changing the climate. So this climate change is the biggest challenge the present human race is facing. So what will happen to the earth? What will happen to the human beings? Because we need to understand in all its seriousness that there is a lurking danger around us. Countries, why did this happen? There's huge competition. There is economic expansion, imperialistic outlook, and so many such things. Countries wanting to expand, and they're using fossil fuels, mostly a cheap economy, and that is causing most of this carbon dioxide, which is changing the climate. So, as we look at the disastrous consequences, what will happen if the climate goes on rising and rising and rising, and the temperature goes on rising, what will happen? As oceans are going to become very, very warm, deserts are going to expand, glaciers will collapse, and then they will flood into the rivers, and so many such things. And the crops, countries like India, which mostly depend on agriculture, when the crops are going to face the drought because of either drought or excess rainfall. Even the seasons are getting changed. The impact of the seasons is not felt. The seasons are either extended or something is happening to that. So the whole cycle is undergoing tremendous changes, and that has its own impact on our own life and the life around us. This is another thing. So why all these things are happening? Because there is no clean energy. There is no clean energy at all. Energy wise, we are really, really very, very, especially in our country, we need to do a lot. And the materials that we use, really, for example, you take plastic. Plastic is such a material which is causing all the havoc, all the hazard. Likewise, if you can take transportation, which causes 24% of total global pollution, that's another big problem. And, likewise, so there is a sort of, pollution generating agents around the world. And the cause again is the human appetite for greed, human appetite for expansion, human ignorance, and education is there, but we are ignorant of the perils and the danger that we are going to face, and our succeeding generations, our children and grandchildren, great-grandchildren are going to face. This is the very hottest debate that's happening around the world, very hottest debate, the most serious crisis ever that's happening to this earth. So, when you take up the transport, most importantly, the road transport causes all the trouble, causes all the damage, causes the entire air to be polluted, because in most of the countries, the transportation system, the road transportation system, uses fossil fuel, petroleum products, the petroleum, which causes maximum air pollution. Do you know that in transportation, fossil fuels contribution of pollution is 97%. 97%, can you imagine? It is not so much with the train tracks or even the flights. What happens is the road travel, the road journey, especially in countries like India with a population of 1.3 billion, you know, the road journey has become so risky, not only in terms of, you know, causing carbon dioxide, but so many other things. A lot of accidents are happening. People are dying on the roads. Young boys and girls are dying on the roads. There's a lot of carbon dioxide. There's a huge traffic congestion across in Hyderabad, Bangalore, Mumbai. You go to places, you will find huge Delhi traffic congestion. And in Delhi, if you go to winter, the kind of weather, the kind of atmosphere you have, it's really very, very pathetic. People are really struggling to survive over there. And all because of, again, this carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. This is what is happening. So there are so many hazards. If you have a train travel, it's fine. It's good, comparatively better. Because the train travel, you know, the trains are comparatively, you know, lesser in CO, in what you call this pollution output. So the road journey is really, really causing this great damage to our climate. Then how, what is to be done by all of us? This world has to wake up to the reality of the dangers. Because we need to ask ourselves a question. We are all knowledgeable. We have gone to the space. We have done everything. We are multidisciplinarily intelligent. We are solving many problems. But when it comes to our own existential crisis, are we looking at ourselves? Are we passing the buck to others? This nation to that nation to this nation. This man to that man to this man. This doesn't help us any longer. So what can we do together as a community, as a global community, what we call in India, Vasudhaika Kutumbam? We all can come together. Governments can think of expanding the rail network, electrifying the rail network, and make train travel accessible to the poorest of the poor with reasonable good comforts and proper pricing. Once that is done, the dependence on the road travel will lessen like anything. And that will lead to reduction in carbon emissions. If you want to have a carbon-free world, this is one of the reasons. And secondly, the clean energy. All our vehicles now depend on conventional energy. We have to go to unconventional. Once you go to unconventional, then you will start seeing reduction in the pollution. Even Paris Agreement 2015 aims at that reduction in carbon production or pollution. So there should be proper reduction. Number three, can we, as a human being, individual human being, again go back to make cycle a partner, a friend? Is it possible? It's healthier, and you will not be causing any pollution to the atmosphere, and you will not change the climate. You can just think about that, whether it's really possible. Next one, when, like the Telangana government is really doing a fabulous job, you know, through Haritaharam. They're reaching every place, planting thousands and lakhs and crores of Karimnagar itself. They planted around 5 lakh plants. Amazing. It's a smart city. So across the state, covering all the geographical area, that's being done. Then as a school, what we can do, we can have a lot of eco clubs. Students and parents can come together and take this message across through, you know, what you call, through awareness programs on climate change. We have to educate people about climate change and the dangers involved in this climate change. It's very important. We will take this message forward through various clubs, eco clubs, and various other activities. It's a very important thing. And secondly, especially in the Indian context, it will be wise on our part to actually stop factory weddings and celebrations, which are causing huge amount of food wastage and also causing a lot of carbon monoxide because of the traffic congestions, huge travel. Travel is necessary when it is actually necessary, but you cannot actually be on the road every time. So that is another thing. And most importantly, we have lost a sense of wonder. Why we are going to places every time? Why we want to go out and out and out? As a human being, we lost that sense of wonder. We want to seek pleasure elsewhere. We don't understand that pleasure is inside us. Happiness is here. Happiness is around you, in the people, in the trees, in the nature, birds, water. That's where the happiness is there. If you leave the place and you want to go to places and places and places, causing this pollution, it's dangerous to you, to me, and to everyone. So please try to find that happiness inside you. That will really be amazing. Then finally, when we do all these things, only remember, this planet is 5 billion years old. And it's going to last another 5 billion years before it plunges into the sun. And the planet should not say that. It tried humanity, but it's not impressed. It's not impressed. So we need to take care of this earth, the planet, the community, the oncoming generations after generations. And countries, rich countries, America and other countries, one small thing. Large may be your wealth. Large may be your reach. Large may be your power. Large may be your scientific knowledge. Large may be your success. But just think, how large is your heart? And what kind of wisdom do you have now? As we progress, only one thing. Revolutions do not happen through legislation. Revolution happens on the ground. It may start with one person, one boy, one girl, one individual, one community, one family, one nation. So it is time we start this revolution, and the revolution can start from Karimnagar itself. So the climate change will have to be stopped. We should go back to pre-industrial era, and then our societies will be absolutely perfectly ensured. So let us take a call right now that we are against this climate change. Thank you.